What's up, guys? Welcome to today's vlog. Today, what I'm going to show you guys is a brand new haircut. I wanted to do a longer haircut this week because you guys have been requesting that. I've also done a lot of short haircuts, a lot of men's cuts, so I want to get back into something a little bit longer. We are using the mannequin today. So today, what we focused on is a nice face frame haircut. I wanted to bring the face frame all the way up into this hairstyle and into the fringe. So the big technique today that we're going to go over is bringing that fringe, cutting the fringe, connecting the face frame into it, and then that's our little police car. Connecting the fringe into the haircut, that's really what this is all about, and also elevation within the face frame. So we've talked about that within the bangs, how you should elevate the hair. Well, now we're gonna work on elevation in the face frame as well. Hope you guys like this video. Let me know in the comments below. Let's get started with our step by step. Here we go. All right, guys, so we're gonna start off this cut, parting the hair straight down the center and then following that directly down center back and then combing each side off to the side. We're basing this haircut off of a center parting, but if you had a guest with a side parting, you could also do that as well. Just start off the haircut parting it on the side they wear it. Now we're gonna create a V shape on the front fringe. And basically the way that I determine how far I want that V to go is where do I want the bangs to stop. So I go all the way out to the edge of the eyebrow and then I braid that section down. You don't have to do this with your guests. You could twist it up. Sometimes that braid annoys people if it's hanging right in front of their face. But sometimes a braid works really well to section off hair instead of using a clip. It's better for presentation. So what we're gonna do is start diagonal back right off of that triangle. So we're gonna follow the head shape down. I'm gonna start creating that face frame so I cut my guide. I decide where I want those pieces to start falling along her face. Then as I move along the head shape starts to move away from me. So the key thing I want you guys to focus on this cut as we work through it is that my elevation on the side of the head is gonna change. I'm gonna elevate more out away from the head towards the camera instead of just bringing it straight over the face. What that's going to do for me is it's going to create that elevation and create more of a lighter face frame for the guest. So now that I'm moving in the back of the head, you can see how high my elevation is compared to the beginning. If you rewind back to the beginning, you can see, but that elevation was right in front of her face. And then as I move to the back of the head, I start to elevate much, much higher to create that light feel. Now, this works for clients that have a super heavy amount of density as you're working through the head shape. But if they have really fine hair, you don't have to elevate as high because you don't want to take out too much weight as well. Also in the front, I grab my guide from a previously cut section. So I just kind of pull a piece over from the opposite side and then I start cutting and I do the exact same thing. We're mimicking the haircut on this side. The reason we're able to mimic the haircut is because it's parted in the center. If it was parted on one of the sides, then I would definitely make sure to adjust my elevation based on the lower density side and the higher density side. I would do definite higher elevation on the higher density side or the side that you part over to. So now we're gonna comb out that fringe area and we're gonna grab one of my favorite tools. This is the carving comb from Donald Scott. I use the 100% carve side. This is available on freesaloneducation.com. It's the best $35 tool you'll ever buy. I'm using the wide tooth version of it. And I just go through with a heavy stroke and create that broken fringe that I'm gonna detail later in the dry cut. So then I add my Braccato foam or Braccato mousse to the haircut and I blow it dry. I'm using a flat wrap technique for the most part, just kind of working the hair all the way around the head and keeping that nozzle aimed down. The reason you have shiny hair is because the cuticle lays nice and flat and it allows the sun to reflect off of it. So if you want to create shiny, smooth hair, you got to keep that nozzle and the air flowing over top of the hair. You don't want to rough it up too much. So then I go through, use my Braccato Vibrastraight iron. This is a really cool iron because it vibrates as it moves down the hair, so it creates less friction on the hair and less damage, which is one of my favorite things about that iron. So now I've got the hair all smoothed out, prepped, and ready to go for my dry cutting. This is the Mizutani 5.5-inch Puffin scissor. We actually just did a class and had a lot of great people in the class, and they were really excited about the Puffin scissor. So this is a good showcase of what it does. The thing I love about having a dry cutting scissor is the fact that dry hair can mess up a scissor. So if you have your main scissor for precision cutting, it's always good to have a dry cutting scissor. It's built to handle the dry hair so that you could see the thicker blade on it. It has more power and works and glides through the hair much better. The blade is also created to glide through the hair. So it's just a good tool to have to keep the life of your scissor, but also have a smoother feel when you're going through and you're slide cutting, point cutting like I'm doing. I'm taking those vertical sections. I'm just doing a nice deep parallel point cut. What that does is it doesn't take out a ton of weight, but just softens the edges, softens the ends of the hair to make them lay really nice and soft in the haircut. I do a little bit of a kind of concave, I guess, kind of whip the hair up a little bit and just detail the ends. And then I go through and I smooth out the bottom. I like to cut the perimeter last for the most part in most haircuts because I don't like to determine the length and base the haircut off of the length that I created. I like to go in and create my layer length first because that's the most important part. Then at the very end, detail the baseline of the haircut. Now we're just going to do a slide cutting technique right through the face frame and in the fringe area. We did get a lot of texture from that Donald Scott carving comb. It was an easy way to quickly cut through the bangs. But now I just go through and detail them with the Puffin scissor, half closing the scissor as I work my way down the hair. You could see that texture that really comes out of it. Finish it off with a little Braccato hairspray. And that is our finished look. I hope you guys like this video. I know it was short and sweet. Definitely watch it a couple times. You'll pick up different things. But I hope you like it. Let me know in the comments below. And thanks for watching. All right, guys, and like always, if you like this haircut, then hit the like button, hit the share button, share this video with all of your friends out there, and also go to fsesocial.com and let me know what you thought of the cut on there as well. That is our social community for hairstylists where you can create a profile, share your work, and get connected to stylists all over the world. Thank you guys so much for the support always. And also check out, you get 20% off on freesaloneducation.com, any scissors, combs, clips, blow dryers, anything you're looking to purchase, you get 20% off if you use the code MattBeckVlog at checkout. So enjoy that. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.